Saying that the prophet was an Arab, but we all know that prophet was.
But even if it was Arab, why is that important? If it was Nigerian, would it be there?
No.
So is it the message of the prophet?
The message.
Okay,
message.
So then we don't need to.
But the message is in Arabic. Why is it in Arabic?
Because that's what the message spoke, right? At the time.
Yeah. Arabic is a universal language.
So is English. So
yeah, I know.
Any language that a person.
Earlier, I made a point. Yeah. Maldives, for example, was a Somali colony, and I think you know they use Somali to interact in other Maldives languages. So, what language do you use to spread the deen? They use this language or whatever that language they were speaking. Not Arabic. They used Arabic because they didn't know anything else to speak.
No, they were taught by teachers.
So you think, I know Sheikh Al-Barqallah went, first of all, he said in Somali.
So why do you know Fafn can speak Arabic?
What do you mean?
If the religion...
He used to speak Arabic.
Yeah, but yeah.
Why was your language before Arabic?
No, he says God will punish
Somali.
Can you speak that?
Still.
So clearly...
No, because we adopted their culture.
Yeah, but then... Listen.
And when people are conquered,
but this guy, he's proud in something that his people created, yeah. And he's remembered. Yeah. This is an Arab thing. Like, I would say to you, there might be some value in learning about your history before at the Arab.
No, I know about my history.
And the culture and the language.
I'm coming. In Islam, before I go, I'm going to make one point. In Islam, it says that if you accept the religion, you become an Arab. That's what it says in Islam.
He reads a lot of fabricated hadith.
Okay, I don't know.
No one's allowed to become an Arab. Even today, they let AI called Sophia become an Arab citizen. No human being.
I apologize about earlier, though.
I always ask questions.
But we're cool, though, innit?
What's Suleiman?
What was the empire you were saying about?
The Ajuran Empire. Ajuran. Yeah, basically.
Jesus was not influenced by the devil. He was not influenced by the devil. The intention of the devil came to have over Jesus did not happen. Jesus, right? That's the point.
I agree. But how can he take it? But it says they took him.
Your premise of saying that all the captives are taken. You're not understanding me.
It's not that. It doesn't say Jesus went.
My 3 minutes is not up.
But can you respond? I know all these things you're saying. The extra thing you're saying, Jesus was not tempted. The devil failed to tempt him. Jesus is not. Okay. How can the devil take him? That's the point.
Remember the story.
So I just asked you a question. Would you go with me if I was a gangster, rapist, a murderer, drug dealer?
I'm not Jesus, am I? Okay. We see from the start of the story was Holy Spirit.
So did Jesus go willingly? Did Jesus go willingly?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
He did.
So Jesus followed the devil.
No, Adnan, come on.
Listen, Adnan. Do you all understand my question?
Adnan, first of all, you're not keeping your word, by the way. You didn't let me finish the point.
Okay, so I'm trying to get to the bottom of it so that we can have a fruitful discussion. But you just admitted that Jesus went willingly. So Jesus followed the devil. The devil took him. It was the devil's wish to go on to the top of the mountain. So the Bible clearly states, Matthew chapter 4 clearly states the devil took him, not the other way around. It wasn't God that took devil. God, who is God? Jesus is God according to them. So it is the devil who took Jesus. So Jesus went willingly. So he followed the devil. Jesus followed the devil to the mountain because the devil took him.
Adnan, how is this the same? How is this the same?
No, it's not worse. This is blasphemy.
Did Jesus overcome the devil in the end?
Okay, let's
did
assume.
Jesus
good question. Good question.
Temptation?
Okay.
Jesus
my sister asked a question.
Thinking that he was having sex for a whole year. We see Jesus was victorious, okay. And that was the whole point.
Very,
of it.
Very good.
Jesus was victorious.
Okay. Okay.
But
that's a very good point. Watch how she will now again not accept my argument based upon her reasoning. She said, did Jesus eventually become victorious? Eventually. at the end become victorious over the devil?
Not eventually. Oh, throughout, actually.
Okay.
Throughout.
How can he be throughout? Okay, then again, the point is, did the devil take him to the mountain, or did Jesus take the devil to the mountain?
You saw at the beginning of the story. You saw at the beginning of the story where it says the Holy Spirit took
no problem.
Jesus
no problem
to
that.
The wilderness.
I,
so we see that it was a God.
I'm not talking about that
thing.
Bit. I'm talking. Okay. I'm specifically concerned with the bit where it says the devil took Jesus to the mountain. Now, when the wording in the Bible, in the Gospel of Matthew chapter 4, is that the devil took him to the mountain, did Jesus go willingly with the devil? You said yes. So then Jesus followed the devil. Yes?
Yes.
Okay.
In that instance,
okay. In
the,
so, so, so,
the
so here, no. Jesus, whether he's a prophet, we believe he's a prophet.
No.
Or whether it's God, you believe he's God. In both cases, for some time, Jesus followed the devil. Right? Yeah, for some time.
You're ignoring the fact.
He willingly went.
Yes. He followed the devil.
You're ignoring.
You're still not focusing on the point.
Anand, you're ignoring. First of all, yes, you didn't respond to that point. But you're ignoring the fact that the Holy Spirit, God Himself, took.
I got that point clearly. The Holy Spirit took Jesus to be tempted.
Exactly.
Okay, good. There's another ditch now. My sister is now saying the Holy Spirit took Jesus to be tempted.
And you're ignoring the fact that each time the devil brought the temptation to Jesus, Jesus overcame.
Okay.
Jesus overcame.
Okay.
Jesus overcame.
Thank you.
Jesus overcame and then said, "Get thee behind me,
okay.
Satan. Get out."
Okay. So why didn't Jesus?
He had authority. That's why he was able to say, "Get out, Satan."
Okay. Good.
But when that influence, that magic, let's use the word magic if you don't like the word the devil, you know, came the witch, when Muhammad was bewitched,
he fought the magic.
Why did it take him a whole God, year?
He overcame.
Why did he say, "Devil, get thee behind me"?
When you finish.
Why did it take him a whole year
of
thinking he was having sex for a whole year?
We have no reference whatsoever in the entire Islamic literary corpus where the prophet followed the devil. Never do we have an example where Prophet Muhammad ever obeyed or followed the devil, right? In fact, when the devil attacked him, he always fought back. In this case, when he was affected by magic, God revealed two final chapters of the Quran to him, what we call Mu'awazatain, right? In these two chapters, God gave him the prayer to protect himself against magic, and he did that prayer, he read that prayer, and he overcame the attacks of the devil. The Prophet of Islam fought the devil. In your case, Jesus, by your standards, by according to your scripture, Jesus obeyed, followed the devil. Now Jesus could have said to the devil, I'm not going to the mountain with you. Jesus could have said to the devil, "You're calling me to go to the mountain. You're trying to take me. I know you're upset. I know you don't like it. I know you're upset. I know you're upset.
I know.
I know. So when Jesus." When Jesus had the chance to say to the devil, "I don't want to go," he didn't say it. To the contrary, Jesus is following the devil to the mountain, because the Bible says, I'm finishing now, chapter 4, the book of Matthew says, that the devil took him to the mountain. She only shows what Christian manners are.
Okay?
And I know better Christians than that. I know beautiful Christians around the world. There are very, very beautiful Christians around the world, very well mannered, beautiful people, unlike you. So you cannot give bad name to Christians. Like some Muslims cannot give bad names to Muslims. So now, coming back to my point, finally. Now you said earlier that the Holy Spirit took Jesus to the devil to be tempted. Right? Yes? Okay. Now we're going to go to the book of James chapter 1, verse 13, where James, the book of James states, God cannot be tempted by evil. God cannot be tempted. The devil is evil. The devil is the epitome of evil. And here she said God took Jesus to be tempted by the devil. Right? In the book of James chapter 1, verse 13, it states God cannot be tempted by evil. Now, I don't know how these guys can justify all this. No, no, no. And I really have to go and pray. Prayer is more, prayer is more important for me.
Fine. We can come because there's a lot of things you said there.
Right.
You're
under the light, you don't see it. You have to come.
I have to go and pray.
Okay, I'll let you. Okay.
I know you're not going to accept. I know you're not going to.
Because there's a lot you said about showing me where Muhammad was influenced.
By the devil. By the devil. Don't read the devil into it. Show me with. I showed you where the devil took Jesus to the mountain and Jesus followed him willingly. Jesus could have said, I don't want to go with you. You're the devil, you're Shaitan, you're the Satan, I don't want to go with you. Why, how can you even, how dare you speak to me like that and take me to the mountain? Thank you very much for listening. God bless you, God bless you. Okay, who's Mike Sadiq?
Thank you very much.
There are two of them.